Thank you. stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. While they can still hear us, let me say thank you again to 12 Times the Lady Ensemble, especially Zachary Marshall, the director, for that wonderful rendition of our national anthem. Thank you so much. Well, good morning. My name is Larry Calhoun, and I'm the Dean of the College, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the hooding and graduation ceremony for the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy, class of 2013. And students, not much longer, students, but as I do each year, I want to give you an opportunity to stand up, find where your family and friends are, and thank them for all they've done to get you here today. So stand up and say thank you to them. Good job. Well, as with the previous three classes that have graduated from our college, the men and women on the stage here today took a chance on East Tennessee State University and took a chance on our College of Pharmacy. If you look at the profile of the students here, their academic profile and their qualifications, they could have gone anywhere to pharmacy school. And they took a risk and chose us. They helped us make this college better than when they found it. And I'm certainly appreciative of that. They helped me recruit. You've helped me establish the student organizations. And you've helped me recruit students that are following you to our school, to your school. Quite simply, everything I've asked you to do, you have done. And as your dean, I want to thank you for that. You know, time doesn't stand still. Lots of things have happened to us since August of 2009. Some good things and some not so good things in our lives. Most of you know I have a composite of each class, and that composite sits on my wall behind my desk. So when I get a particularly difficult day, I just spin around in my chair, look at the composites, and realize why I'm here and what my job is. And I was doing that yesterday, looking at your composite, and some of you have really changed since August of 2009. But all for the good, all for the good. It was fun watching all the pictures that you shared with the audience while they were waiting for you. A lot of memories. A very nice video that Joy put together about all the things that have happened over the last 4 years yesterday. And I can say quite comfortably that you have left your mark on the Gatton College of Pharmacy in a very positive way, of course. And they get tired of me saying this, but it's the truth. They've been pioneers to help establish something that's going to be around for a long, long time. And you have helped do that, helped make it what it is today. And once again, Dr. Bishop, if a measure of whether you let me keep my job one more year is the quality of the students on the stage, I think I'm safe for one more year. So thank you. As I told you last week during your board reviews, this is the last time that you will all ever be together, most likely. And I want you to embrace this time, because you can't repeat it. And one last thing. I've mentioned this to the other classes that have graduated. If you remember back to your white coat ceremony, August 2009, and you remember I told you that when you put on that white coat, there's responsibility that comes with it, immediate responsibility. And the responsibility is that people are going to see you differently and ask you questions, ask you advice. And you remember what I told you? Don't give the advice yet. Well, today, I'm happy to say I have permission from the faculty to say you are ready and you can give that advice now. So congratulations for that. I'm really proud of each and every one of you, and thank you for choosing me. Thank you for allowing me to be your dean. You can't take that away from me. Whether you want to or not, I'll always be your dean, so thank you. You know, thank you. You know, we've been visited by the Accreditation Council on Pharmacy Education a number of times, and one of the things that they've said every time that they came here was the thing that impressed them was the quality of the faculty of the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy. They also recognized in their reports other groups of individuals that help make this a unique kind of College of Pharmacy. Our preceptors, the college staff, our donors, and also our residents, our PGY2 residents. And by the way, I'm happy to say that a new milestone has occurred in that our residency program just in the last month received full accreditation status from the American Society of Health System Pharmacists. Just another mark that we have really good students and really good faculty. So if you're a member, yeah, thank you. That's good. So if you're a member of the faculty, our staff, our preceptors, our donors, or our residents, would you please stand and let us say thank you? You know, this is the time in the program where I usually get to introduce Mrs. Martha Culp, but she cannot be here with us today. This is the first graduation or white coat ceremony that Mrs. Culp has not been able to be here. Hopefully, through live streaming, Mrs. Culp, we miss you and thank you for all that you've done. This room that you're in is named in her honor. She was our very first donor for the Gatton College of Pharmacy. And we expect to see you at the white coat ceremony in August. She just celebrated her 97th birthday. So thank you, Mrs. Culp. I would also like to welcome the First Lady of East Tennessee State University, Mrs. Donna Nolan. Donna, would you stand and let us say welcome and thank you for coming today. I'm always appreciative when one of my peers in the academic health sciences and our deans come and share in our graduation. And Dr. Randy Wyckoff, Dean of the College of Public Health, is here today. Randy, would you stand and let us say thank you for being here. I would also like to recognize Dr. Melanie Angles, who is a member of the class of 2012, who later on this morning will be leading the class of 2013 in the Oath of the Pharmacist. So, Melanie, would you stand and let us say thank you for being here. You're going to hear a number of awards given out today. We have three student awards that are named in the honor of individuals. Individuals who played a very important role in establishing this college and its development. Those people are Gabby Wilson Jr., Bettina Black, and with us today at our ceremony, Mr. Gary Mabry. Gary, would you stand and let us say thank you for all you did for the college. Now, I'd be remiss, I just noticed my mother and father in the audience today. I can get in real trouble if I don't say welcome, Raymond and Pearl Calhoun. Thank you for being here. Stand up and let me say thank you. I I don't think they realize it, but it is the 40th anniversary where they went, made this little trip to Memphis where I got my hood in 1973. So thanks for helping me get here. Thank you. I'm going to now introduce our stage party, and let me start by introducing Dr. Brian Odle, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmacy Practice, who was elected by the class as one of the hooders today. Dr. Odle. Dr. Brooks Pond, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences. Dr. Pond was also elected as a class hooder by the class. Dr. David Roan, Chair, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences. Dr. Ralph Lugo, Chair, Department of Pharmacy Practice. Dr. Michael Crouch, Executive Associate Dean for Academic Affairs. And Mr. Steve Ellis, Assistant Dean for Student Affairs. Miss and soon to be Dr. Carolyn Combs, who will be speaking later today representing the class of 2013. Mr. Paul Montgomery, who is our region's representative to the Tennessee Board of Regents. Mr. Robert White, our region's representative to the Tennessee Higher Education Commission. Dr. Wiltsey Bishop, Vice President for Health Affairs and University Chief Operating Officer. And finally, before I introduce one more individual who will come and share comments with the class and the audience, let me note that we'll follow the printed agenda for the rest of the ceremony without further introductions from the podium. Dr. Brian Nolan was appointed the 9th president of East Tennessee State University in January of 2012. Prior to that time, Dr. Nolan's most recent position was chancellor, West Virginia Higher Education Policy Commission. He received his BA from West Virginia University, his MA from West Virginia University, and his PhD from the University of Tennessee. I think it's safe to say that Dr. Nolan has made a strong statement to East Tennessee State University and to the community that he intends to lead our university to the next level. He's already spent a great deal of time dealing with us in the College of Pharmacy by coming over and visiting and learning about what we do. And the first group he wanted to meet with was happened to be our students, which says a lot. We continue to be excited about his passion for higher education and his vision for East Tennessee State University. Please join me in welcoming our president, Dr. Brian Nolan, to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Calhoun, and good morning to each of you. To the family members of our students today, thank you for all that you have done to make today possible. Today is the culmination of a life journey. Today is the culmination of investments that began at childhood, and it's a pleasure to see so many young children in the audience today. Thank you for all that you have done to make today possible. I'm honored to be here as we celebrate the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy class of 2013, a group of men and women who personify the qualities of excellence and dedication that embody this great institution. For each of you, the degree bestowed upon you today presents an opportunity to enjoy a rewarding career and to do remarkable things and to make a difference in your community. Each of you have already made a difference by achieving your goal of becoming a pharmacist, and it took a great degree of dedication to achieve that goal. But as you transition from this institution, I hope that you remain ever vigilant and dedicated in your passion for learning. Many of you will serve as role models in your community. Many of you will serve as healthcare providers in your community. Many of you will be parents. You'll be members of your church community. But most importantly, you'll be alumni of East Tennessee State University. As you transition from here today, take a piece of this institution with you. Wear your blue and gold as you practice. Talk about the memories that you've made at this institution, but share that passion of learning, that passion that carried you through to the realization of this dream today. I'm extremely proud of your accomplishments, not only as undergraduates, but I look forward to your accomplishments as you move forward into your chosen field of excellence. Best wishes to you and Godspeed.
Good morning. Thank you, Dean Calhoun. It is a pleasure to be here today to celebrate the accomplishments of these outstanding students who are on the stage before you. And it's pretty obvious as I look out in the audience that there are a lot of happy faces. You will begin to hear a theme that Dr. Nolan just pronounced for you, that the people who are in the audience really made a difference in helping to get you here today. So it's a special occasion for the families and friends, as well as it is a recognition of the accomplishments of our graduates. So students, let me give you my heartfelt congratulations. It really does seem like only yesterday that you were on stage receiving your white coats. But during that time, since those days of the white coat ceremony, you have come together as a class. You've spent hours in study, but you've also spent important time together with your faculty and your classmates in questioning and inquiry and sometimes having fun. But all of the things that you've done over the past few years have shaped you into what you have become today and have prepared you for your future. On a personal note, I really want to thank this class for what you've done to help our interprofessional initiative in the Academic Health Science Center. You all have taken the lead, and I'd like to say special thanks to Aaron Hankins. Aaron, would you stand up? Aaron founded the Association of Interprofessional Health Students that has made a significant difference to all of the students in the Academic Health Science Center here at ETSU, and I believe will be a model for interprofessional student organizations for the whole country. So Aaron, thank you and your colleagues who helped you found this wonderful organization. As a pharmacist, the future holds many opportunities for each of you. And because of your education at the Gatton College of Pharmacy, I know you are well prepared to make a difference in your profession and to those you serve. I encourage you to feel confident about your abilities as you give that advice that Dr. Calhoun has given you permission to give, and to make a difference to those you serve. It's a special day for you. Please enjoy it. Please take the opportunity to thank those people who are in the audience today who have worked hard along the way for you to achieve this significant degree attainment. You might be surprised how important it is to them, too. And finally, one last bit of advice. You got a lot of great advice yesterday at your prescription for success, but one last bit of advice is that as you leave East Tennessee State Gatton College of Pharmacy, remember that you are now alumni and that your support to the College of Pharmacy and those who follow after you is extremely important. Be good alumni, be good supporters, and come back to see us often. Congratulations and Godspeed.
Good morning to each of you. It's an honor for me to be here today. Dean Calhoun, thank you for asking me to be here on behalf of the Board of Regents. I consider it a privilege to be in the company of so many friends and colleagues who are here today, as well as those leaders of tomorrow. Members of the Bill Gatton College Pharmacy Class of 2013, I'm referring to you. It is you who are our leaders of tomorrow, and so I will speak to you more now directly. Each of you are about to take on the next step in a journey that, by virtue of your accomplishment, it's already remarkable. By earning your Doctor of Pharmacy degree from ETSU, there's no ceiling on how you may go and the number of lives you can reach. As a pharmacist, you have a bright future in front of you, as well as a great responsibility to shoulder, because you will be a member of one of the world's most respected professions. You will be a powerful thread in the fabric of the community. When people around you are searching for barometers of excellence, they will look to you as a standard measure. So as you go forth, be mindful of doing this university, your college, and your region proud. On behalf of Tennessee Board of Regents, I commend you on a job well done and say congratulations.
I have a little surprise here for our next speaker. Are you surprised?
Yes.
All right. Good. That's good. That's good. That's the way it's supposed to happen. Dr. Nolan and Dr. Bishop, if you'll join me. Robert White has not missed a graduation. He has not missed a white coat ceremony. He has been here since day one helping us establish this College of Pharmacy in various roles, especially as an important member of our community. He is actually leaving to take another position in another state, and this will be his last official graduation. You can come back every year if you would like. But we, on behalf of the college and all of our faculty, staff, and students, we'd just like to say thank you for all you've done for the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy. Thank you, sir.
And yes, that was a surprise. Thank you. No. Thank you for the kind introduction, Dean Calhoun. And thank you for the honor and the privilege to be a part of this wonderful celebration here today. And the pride that I feel for the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy will be something that will never, ever leave my memory. I've been here, as you've mentioned, for the white coat ceremonies and the hooding ceremonies for each class at the College of Pharmacy. But at the privilege of being here today with this class, I thank you for this privilege. And on behalf of the Tennessee Higher Education Commission, I'm truly glad to be here. And of course, this will be my last opportunity before this will be taken up by my predecessor. So with your Doctor of Pharmacy degree in hand, a limitless future lays ahead of you. The challenges you've met and the knowledge you gained will enable you to do remarkable things. Your achievement means great things for this region, because so many of you will remain here and work here, or at least be close to here, we hope. Our communities will be the stronger for it. Northeast Tennessee is my home, always will be my home. No matter where I go, no matter where I am, I will always remember this is my home. The people and the places here is what makes this region so special. This college, this university are among those special places in my heart. When I'm asked about East Tennessee State University or the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy, you can be certain that I will always speak with great pride. On behalf of the Tennessee Higher Education Commission, I say to you members of the class of 2013, congratulations on your achievement.
To the Gatton College of Pharmacy, faculty and staff, family members, friends, and honored guests, on behalf of the graduating class of 2013, thank you. Thank you for being here to share in this special occasion. Without your love, support, patience, and encouragement, we wouldn't be on this stage today celebrating our graduation as pharmacists. To my classmates, thank you so much for electing me to be your secretary treasurer for the last 4 years and for giving me the honor of speaking on your behalf today. When presented with the opportunity to give a speech for graduation, I asked myself, what am I going to say? As any of my classmates would have done when faced with answering a pharmacy-related question that they didn't have an answer for, I remembered the important survival tactic that we all learned while in pharmacy school. When you don't know the answer to a question, the appropriate response is, I'm unsure of how to answer your question, but I'm happy to look it up and get back with you. So I did just that. I looked for an answer. Rest assured, I did a thorough literature review regarding commencement speeches, a search that would even make Dr. Lugo proud. PubMed turned up no relevant results when I searched the topic graduation. In fact, at one point it asked, "Did you mean radiation?" I searched for an evidence-based approach to delivering pharmacy graduation speeches and the graduation speech guidelines. But my search left me empty-handed. I hate to admit it, but it looks like I'm going to have to wing this. I turned to Google and YouTube. and found that most graduation speeches carry the same theme. The theme is, what have we done and what are we going to do? I found this to be a daunting task because we've done so much over the past 4 years, from meeting at PharmaConnect or orientation, memorable courses like pathophysiology and pharmacology, Dr. Hurley breaking a stick over his head in biochemistry, in-class exercises with Dr. Brown, IPPEs, group work, and more group work during our P3 year, and finally, 9 APPE rotations. We've done so much over the past 4 years that it would be impossible to reflect on it all today. I found the list of the things we haven't done while in pharmacy school to be much shorter. So today I'd like to talk about some of the things we haven't done while in pharmacy school. 1, we didn't sleep. And if we did, it was never enough. 2, we didn't spend as much time with family, significant others, and friends as we would have liked. And 3, we didn't have any money. Now that we're graduating, I wish you long nights of restful sleep, more time to enjoy family and friends, and that we all win the lottery or we're never going to be able to pay our student loans. A graduation speech wouldn't be complete without some words of wisdom. Let's be happy that this journey happened, not sad that it's coming to an end. Today is a day of celebration. We did it. And since no graduation speech is complete without an inspirational quote, in the words of the infamous Kool in the Gang, celebrate good times. Come on. Thank you again and best wishes.
Thank you, Carolyn, for those wonderful words. And thank you, Dr. Calhoun. First, let me say how pleased that Dr. Crouch and I are to have this opportunity to recognize members of the class for their academic and professional accomplishments. The students being honored here today have demonstrated commitment and excellence in learning the art and science of pharmaceutical practice and patient care, and have been selected by faculty and administration to receive these various distinctions. The names and descriptions of the awards appear on the last page of your programs. So for purposes of time this morning, I will read only the name of the award and announce the recipient. The first award is the American Pharmacists Association Academy of Student Pharmacists Senior Recognition Award. And this year it is presented to Brandy Van Hoy Anders. The next award, the Gatton College of Pharmacy Patient Care Award, is presented to Helen Joanne Mason. Next is the Lilly Achievement Award. The recipient of this award is Laura Beth Parsons. The next award is the Merck Award, for which there are actually two recipients. The first, Brandy Van Hoy Anders. And the second, Sarah Leanne McLean. The Mylan Institute of Pharmacy Excellence in Pharmacy Award is presented to Courtney Denise Clark. The following two awards recognize achievement in the area of natural and complementary medicine. The first of these awards, the Natural Standard Research Collaboration Award, goes to Matthew Kenneth Pickering. The second award, Natural Medicine's Comprehensive Database Award, is presented by Therapeutic Research Center, goes to James L. Ledford. Now, James, I could be mean and let you get all the way back, but since you're up here, I'd like to announce that you are also the recipient of the Pharmacist Mutual Book Award. You want to try for a third? No, just kidding. Right. Teva Pharmaceuticals sponsors the Outstanding Student Award. The recipient of this award is Courtney Elizabeth Petrie. The Walters Kluwer Health Fact and Comparison Award for Outstanding Communication Skills is presented to Carolyn Clark Combs. The final academic award is the Valedictorian Award. This award is presented to the highest ranking student in the graduation class. Indicative of the overall academic strength of the class of 2013 is the fact that the Valedictorian Award is shared by two students who achieved perfect grade point averages. The 2013 valedictorians are James Linus Ledford, and Brandy Van Hoy Anders. The Gatton College of Pharmacy is proud to present the next awards in recognition of three individuals whose support and advocacy played an important role in the college's establishment and growth. The first of these awards is the Gary Mabry Community Service Award in recognition and appreciation of his countless efforts to make our community a better place to live. And we are pleased that Mr. Mabry is here today. The Gary Mabry Community Service Award goes to Courtney Elizabeth Petrie. The next award is the Bettina M. Black Leadership Award, presented in recognition of Dr. Black's visionary leadership to advance the profession within the state and the nation. The Bettina M. Black Leadership Award goes to Aaron Lee Hankins. The final award is the Guy B. Wilson Jr. Leadership Award, given in recognition of Dr. Wilson's leadership in the local pharmacy community and commitment to establish a College of Pharmacy at East Tennessee State University. The Guy B. Wilson Jr. Leadership Award goes to Carolyn Clark Combs. Congratulations to all of the award recipients.
All right, the time I think you've been waiting for. Would the candidates for the Doctor of Pharmacy degree please rise for the conferring of degrees? President Nolan, the candidates now standing have completed all requirements of the Doctor of Pharmacy degree, and on behalf of the faculty, I recommend they be conferred the degrees to which they are entitled.
By the authority vested in me by the Tennessee Board of Regents, and upon the recommendation of your faculty, I now confer upon each of you the Doctor of Pharmacy degree to which you are entitled, with all of the rights, privileges, amenities, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. As you come forward when your name is called, it would be my honor to present you with your diploma.
The stage party could take its position. The academic hood that the students receive today consists of a blue and gold chevron representing the colors of East Tennessee State University, and it is trimmed in olive green velvet, signifying the discipline of pharmacy. Yasin M. Andani. Brandy Van Hoy Anders. Emmanuel Blake Lee Bippus. Nakisa Buchanan Blevins. Jessica McGuire Buchanan. Davina Dawn Campbell. Rebecca Ann Carlson. Hannah Beth Carmack. Tina Young Choi. Ashley Lenora Christian. Courtney Denise Clark. Joshua Nolan Cloyd. Kylie Ann Coleman. Carolyn Clark Combs. Hannah Jordan Cox, being hooded by her father, Dr. Jack Cox, who in addition to being a physician, is a pharmacist. Aaron Armstrong Cup. Robert Thomas Davis. Thank you. Carrie Helene Dickinson Terry. Amelia Younger Elongwe. Stephanie Gordon Elliott. Katie Elizabeth Fields. Elizabeth Raphael Gamble Fralin. Daniel Ray Garrett. Tashana Ashley Gilliam. Joshua Thomas Graham. Mark Andrew Gimond. Clarence Dabgima Gwabamuga. Selma Hambo. Yeah. Aaron Lee Hankins. Ramez Moheb Hanna. Aaron Thomas Harrell. Robert Scott Hayes. Hannah Starr Higgins. Robin Saskia Holman, being hooded by her father, Mr. Bob Holman.
Thank you.
All right.
Emily Ruth Hughes. Christy Danielle King. Aaron Michael Lambert. Stephen Anthony Lance. James L. Ledford. Rebecca Jane Leinert. Dondrell Antoine Lester. Yashin Liu. Eric Randall Lochner. Rebecca Leanne Loden. Courtney Chase Mabe. Helen Joanne Mason. Rebecca Ashley McCaffrey. Sarah Leanne McLean. Morgan Elizabeth Pennington Meade. Jamie Atkins Montgomery. Laura Beth Parsons, being hooded by her father, Mr. Stephen Brown. Jasmine Umesh Patel. Hunter Matthew Perrin. Matthew Kenneth Pickering. Courtney Elizabeth Petrie, being hooded by her grandfather, Mr. Vincent Chapuis. Sabrina Larum Pollard. Ashley Suzanne Poole. Rebecca Suzanne Pope. Andrew Taylor Reed. Christopher Reyes Reguyal. Alex Kyler Rhodes. Emily Vaughn Ritchie, being hooded by her mother, Mrs. Celia Neff Vaughn. Benjamin Murphy Samuels. Eric William Schell. Olga Slanopoulos. Amber Music Smith. Lauren Sue Stanton. Lindsay Ann Stone. George Brian Tipton. Arissa Brooke Vaughn. Andrew Charles White. Anthony Haven Williams.
Hey, go Anthony.
Wait.
Robert Albert Winter III. Kevin Ray Wolf. As the stage party returns to their seat, we're going to deviate slightly from what's in the written program, and I'd like to invite Dr. Calhoun back to the podium, please.
Well, thank you for allowing us to deviate just slightly. We have a special ritual that we decided to include today in today's ceremony. One of our graduates, now Dr. Robin S. Holman, will be carrying on a family tradition by entering the United States Air Force in service to our country. Robin desires to be surrounded by her pharmacy family as she takes this next step. And as her dean, I couldn't be more proud. At this time, I'd like to invite Major Dale Anderson of the East Tennessee State University ROTC Battalion to come forward.
Dr. Holman, come forward.
Congratulations, class of 2013. While each of you may be excited and nervous to start the new road that starts ahead, I urge you to take time to consider the oath that you are about to take. This represents your responsibility to be well-informed and compassionate as a pharmacist for the rest of your career. As you go into the world and begin your new lives, love your patients. Continue to learn as much about the world as the world will let you, and stay mindful of the mark which you will make on the future of pharmacy. At this time, I would like to ask the students to please stand and read this oath with me. As the students are rising, I also invite all pharmacists to present to stand and recite the oath. If you're looking for the oath, it's in the inside back cover of the program. I promise to devote myself to a lifetime of service to others through the profession of pharmacy in fulfilling this vow. I'll consider the welfare of humanity and relief of suffering my primary concerns. I will apply my knowledge, experience, and skills to the best of my ability to assure optimal outcomes for my patients. I will respect and protect all personal and health information entrusted to me. I will accept the lifelong obligation to improve my professional knowledge and competence. I will hold myself and my colleagues to the highest principles to our professional morale, ethical, and legal conduct. I will embrace and advocate changes that improve patient care. I will utilize my knowledge, skills, experiences, and values to prepare the next generation of pharmacists. I take these vows voluntarily with a full realization of the responsibility with which I am entrusted by the public.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you the Bill Gatton College of Pharmacy class of 2013. Faculty go. Ladies and gentlemen, your graduates have marched in this perfect straight line all the way to the ballroom upstairs for a reception. We'd like to invite you to meet them there. Also, we'll have the College of Pharmacy building open this afternoon if you would like to have a tour of where they spent the last 4 years. And since the College of Medicine will be using this facility shortly, we'd ask that you make your way to the ballroom. Thank you for coming.